Yesterday, Republican Senator Ted Cruz decided to appear on CNN opposite Chris Cuomo to talk about many things. One of the things, obviously, was Donald Trump's debate performance. And, you know, Chris Cuomo, like every other American in this country, wanted to ask a Republican, why couldn't your guy just say white supremacists are bad? Why couldn't he disavow them? And then Ted Cruz did a Ted Cruz thing with his smug, very punchable face. And Chris Cuomo wouldn't have any of that yesterday. Like, again, like the rest of America, he's tired of it. He's sick of it. And so this is just one of many altercations that happened during Ted Cruz's segment with Chris Cuomo. Take a look.
And say, was the president wrong to go soft on the Proud Boys in the debate last night?
Oh, look, I wish he had been much clearer in his denunciation. I was glad today that he walked that back.
And, no, he didn't.
And he, look, I'm glad that he sought to walk it back. I'm glad his campaign sought to walk it back. But let me be clear also, the press is completely hypocritical on this issue.
Really?
The press is partisan in this regard. So 10 years ago, 2010, Joe Biden gave a eulogy for Robert Byrd, who was a grand cyclops of the KKK. Yeah. That's 10 years ago.
You're really going to go with that?
Oh, yeah. You
I know
better
you're
believe
a master
it.
Debater, and Professor Dershowitz tells me you were the smartest student he ever had at Harvard Law. You're going to go with that weak-ass argument here? Byrd, who had a complete enlightenment about how hate was wrong, who changed his life, who spoke about it,
Chris, have you ever eulogized a Klansman? I'll give you another example.
But no, hold on. That's your example. You're going to use
that. No, I'll give you another one. I'll give you a lot of examples.
But hold on, because I don't want you to run away from the premise, Senator. I'm not you, but I'm not a fool either.
I can't tell you how exciting it is to finally see somebody on national television, you know, real cable news, calling out a Republican for, as Cuomo put it, having a weak-ass argument. I love that. I love that he said it. I love that he left the word ass in there. Because it's about time that somebody in the corporate media called out the Republicans who are always trying to say, well, the Democrats, y'all knew a racist like 80 years ago. You know, the KKK 150 years ago was started by a Democrat. Things have changed. Actually, I don't know if Republicans know this. I know they haven't wanted things to change in the last 150 years, but they have. The Democratic Party today doesn't stand for what the Democratic Party 150 years ago did. Neither does the Republican Party. There have been realignments. There have been shifts. So yeah, the Democrats may have founded it, but those Democrats then would be considered Republicans now. And it's a weak-ass argument to argue anything else. And as for Byrd, as Cuomo pointed out, Byrd repented. Byrd tried to make amends. Byrd admitted he was wrong. And isn't that what we all want to see happen with people? We want to see the growth. We want to see them say, oh, wow, I was wrong on this issue. How can I make it better now? Let me devote time to it, which is what happened in that particular instance. But they don't want to see that. They don't want to see it because it runs counter to their narrative. And their narrative is that we can't possibly be racist because we're the party of Lincoln. Yeah, Lincoln wouldn't touch you with a 10-foot pole, Ted Cruz. And of course, as I mentioned, there were several other blow-ups in that interview with Cuomo and Ted Cruz. In fact, the one we just showed was actually one of the tamer ones. But I chose to focus on that one because that's the one that has real substance to it. Cuomo did also point out that, you know, Cruz is defending the guy who called his wife ugly. Humorous, but there's no substance to that, which is why, you know, I want to focus on that particular argument. Because this is an argument that Cruz tried to make there by bringing up the Robert Byrd thing. It is similar to all of the other arguments we see from other Republicans trying to make, saying that, no, Democrats are actually the racist ones. Democrats are the ones who, you know, oh, you eulogized Robert Byrd. Oh, you founded the KKK more than a century ago. Y'all are the racists. We freed the slaves. No. Lincoln and his cabinet and his administration and the winning of a war freed the slaves. That has nothing in common with any of today's modern Republicans. You certainly wouldn't fight over that. You wouldn't go to the battlefield for that unless we told you the slaves were covered in oil. Then maybe you'd fight because you'd want them. But you're nothing like that. Democrats are nothing like the Democrats were back then. Things change. As much as Republicans don't want them to, things still change, and we're not the same parties anymore, and thank God for that.